Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Rika Rahimah. I am from Class A, English Education Study Program, School of Postgraduate Studies, Universitas Pendidikan Indonesia. In this occasion, I'd like to present my chapter report entitled Developing Autonomous Learners in Japan, Working with Teachers Through Professional Development. The application is submitted as a partial fulfillment of the assignments in EFL Teaching Methodology course lectured by Professor Dr. Nenden Sri Lengkanawati, M.Pd, with Dr. Fazri Nur Yusuf, M.Pd. For the presentation outline, it will be elaborated into 5 points. The first one is the summary of the topic, and then related theories, related research reports, critical analysis, and the last one is the conclusion. Explanation is the summary of the topic. So as I mentioned before, that the title of the paper is Developing Autonomous Learners in Japan, Working with Teachers Through Professional Development. So this paper is in the book entitled Language Learner Autonomy, Teachers' Beliefs and Practices in Asian Context, edited by Barnard and Lee in 2016. Meanwhile, this paper is in chapter 3 of that book, in page 43 to 61, with the author Strobe, Randall, and Tomita, and year of publication is in 2016, with its publisher Angkor Thom Printer Company Limited. And the paper of organization are elaborated into 5 points. The first one is introduction that covers a brief definition of LA, several related studies of LA, the burning issue regarding LA in Japan, and the research questions. And the methodology covering methodology used to conduct the research to implement LA in Japan, and the result and discussion is providing the result to the research and relating the result. Conclusion that provides a brief summary of what has been done in the research and also the recommendation for the future research. And lastly, references that contain lists of works or ideas that are cited on the research paper. The burning issue of the research. So, learner autonomy, which abbreviated as LA, is commonly defined as learners taking responsibility for their own learning, is believed to improve motivation, engagement, and overall academic performance of the students. However, the appropriateness of the concept has been contested in Asia. Strobe, Randall, and Tomita begin their research by considering the issue of LA in the light of stereotypes of Japanese learners as passive and reactive. So the discussion about education in Japan often begin with references to the culturally determined deference to authority and shyness or other such aspects of learner characteristics in Japan. Such characteristics are often deployed to explain the poor state of English proficiency in the country, according to Randall 2009 and Stewart and Erie in 2012, which is evinced by Japan registering an average score which is consistently lower than that most of countries in East and Southeast Asia for the test of English as a foreign language, or as we know as TOEFL, based on Educational Testing Service in 2015 and Yoshida in 2009. The second one is the purpose of the research, aimed to find out students' readiness for autonomy, the practices used for developing learner autonomy, and the constraints on promoting learner autonomy in Japan. This can be seen from three research questions that has offered by the researchers, which are, first, what is the instructor's understanding of learner autonomy? And then, what obstacles exist to the development of learner autonomy? What is the impact of professional development workshops on the development of learner autonomy? Next is the methodology of the research. So for the participants of this research, it involved 16 language and content teachers in a private Japanese university. And for the data collection of this research, it used online questionnaire, individual semi-structured interviews, and 2 workshops. For the data analysis of the questionnaire, It was analyzed using descriptive statistics, and for the interviews, those were recorded and transcribed for later analysis, and for the two workshops, those were video recorded for later analysis. Went into result and discussions of the research. So from the questionnaire, the responses on the questionnaire reflect an overall positive attitude to developing autonomy in the classroom. And secondly, there was strong positive agreement among the instructors relating to the desirability of learners to be involved in all aspects of their learning. It is indicated by 14 of the participants indicated agreement or strong agreement with the statements that learners of all ages can develop learner autonomy. Secondly, concerning the meaning of learner autonomy, the majority of the instructors, which are above 80%, indicated agreement or strong agreement with statements indicating that autonomy includes the ability for learner to make choices about how they learn and what they learn, to choose their own learning, to choose their own material, and then to have some control over the activities they do. However, the instructors did not believe that learner autonomy excludes the involvement of the teacher, but rather that instructors continue to have a strong influence on supporting learner autonomy. And overall, the instructors believed that learner autonomy had a positive effect on the level of the success achieved by individual learners. For the workshop and the interview, the workshop provided an opportunity for the clarification of a concept with which they may not have been very familiar. For instance, 8 of the English language educators indicated that the workshop had reminded them of the importance of promoting learner autonomy in their classroom, which many of them were doing already, yet the workshop to reflect on and make their implementation more explicit. Secondly, the involvement in the two-semester study had been beneficial in that they had gained a better understanding of the concept of autonomy and the autonomy framework. So, during the workshop and the first round of interviews, the instructors were able to identify a number of obstacles to implementing activities to enhance learner autonomy in their classes. The most common obstacle identified was a lack of teacher autonomy based on a restrictive curriculum, a tight schedule of points that must be covered in class, and then or a time allotted for a class in reference to the objective that needed to be achieved. Student characteristics were also identified as obstacles, including low English language proficiency, which inhibits the student's ability to understand explanation of the concept of autonomy and the rationale for specific activities and to plan and reflect in meaningful detail or accuracy. The results of the research showed an impact on both instructors' understanding of the concept of learner autonomy and their willingness and ability to implement learner autonomy, enhancing activities in their classroom. Secondly, in order for instructors to create a learning environment where students can develop their learner autonomy, not only students but also instructors need to be provided with sufficient support. This is related with teachers' professional development or PD. Second explanation in my chapter report is about related theories that explain the nature of learner autonomy and then some definitions based on experts and then teacher roles in fostering learner autonomy and teacher professional development in enhancing learner autonomy as well. So firstly, I'm going to explain the nature of learner autonomy. So the concept of learner autonomy was first introduced by Krapel, University of Nancy, France, in the early 1970s, with Henry Holleck as its former director, according to Holleck in 1981. And then, there are some definitions of learner autonomy based on three experts. Firstly, from Holleck in 1981, he describes learner autonomy as people's ability to take charge of their own learning arose for practical through idealistic reasons, while little perceives autonomy as a capacity. It is a capacity to be able to critically reflect the learning process, be able to obtain great decision making, and has an independent action. While Benson, 2011, defines LA, or learning autonomy, as the capacity to control one's own learning, which leads to significant measure of independence from the control of others. According to Darling Hammond et al., 2009, there are four teacher roles in fostering learner autonomy. Firstly, a teacher needs to provide students with opportunity for deep and meaningful learning, thereby fostering their holistic development. Secondly, they are able to work collaboratively with others, including colleagues and parents, and then able to seek out opportunities for further learning within and beyond the school. And lastly, able to possess certain personal values that allow them to act as leaders of social change. They need to be able to maintain high-quality content instruction while adopting a social justice orientation, helping students to recognize and undermine patterns of injustice and oppression. In this 21st century, teachers are expected to play a variety of roles in school. Fulfilling these roles require a wide range of professional and personal competencies, according to Darling Hammond et al., 2009. So, since that learner autonomy is one of the educational objectives in this 21st century, therefore, teachers as facilitators need to obtain one of these goals through their professional development. In relation for learner autonomy, high-quality professional development must provide teachers with active learning opportunities, including activities to engage in exploration, reflection, and discussion, context for collective participation and collegial constructive and non-prescriptive feedback, and sustained follow-up support after program completion, according to Bautista et al. 2015, DeSimone 2009, and Sherwin and Hand 2004. The next point that will be explained is related research reports. Firstly, Lengkanawati in 2017 conducted a descriptive study about teachers' belief about LA and its implementation in Indonesian EFL setting. The study involved Indonesian English teachers from secondary level to tertiary level who were currently pursuing advanced degrees. Lengkanawati 2017 investigated teachers' belief regarding LA and their practices in the classroom. Also, the teachers were involved in a FGD or focus group discussion during two workshops to further examine their beliefs of LA. In addition, a questionnaire was sent to the teachers to examine their beliefs about LA. It was found out that the teachers in the present study believed that autonomy should be nurtured among learners and that learner autonomy should not be translated as learning without a teacher. Then, the teachers believed that LA could be promoted through learners making choices about how they learn and what the activities they do and through involving them in these choices. The LA training also provided a positive impact towards the teachers. Warni and Supratinisi 2019 conducted a research on developing LA and, more importantly, on how visible it is based on teachers' perception. How teachers perceive learner autonomy will thus influence how much and how teachers promote it. In turn, it will determine the opportunities that learners have to become autonomous. The study involved 105 EFL teachers teaching in secondary level. Using questionnaire, Warni and Supratinisi wanted to know the visibility of the LA in their context. The findings show that teacher perceived that it is possible to involve students in making decisions of some aspects related to classroom learning with different degree of visibility. With regards to the existing theories of the learner autonomy, the findings of the study indicated a necessity for continuous professional development program for EFL teaching EFL English teachers, with the concern on the understandings of the learner autonomy and how to promote it in different contexts. And then Nabila, in 2019, in her undergraduate paper, conducted a qualitative study to investigate the perceptions of LA within students and teachers in Indonesian EFL setting. The students and the teachers' overall perception of learner autonomy in general were identified. So the study was conducted with 63 students and 2 teachers teaching at secondary school in Indonesia. The data were obtained through students' questionnaire and teachers' interview. Based on the result of the interview with the teachers, they have positive perceptions about learner autonomy, and the outcomes of the study also showed that the teachers believed that students should be involved in decisions about learning and that the students have the potential to become more autonomous learners. However, the majority of the students were unfamiliar with the term of LA, and the teachers recommended that they should try to promote LA more in their courses by revising the curriculum and then redesigning the courses and giving freedom to students to choose their topics for projects and assignments. Then we've come to my critical analysis regarding learner autonomy. Firstly, LA is one of the essential skills to be acquired in this 21st century era. Secondly, there are several constraints in implementing LA, particularly in the EFL setting, and I divided that into 2 reasons: internal reasons and external reasons. For the internal reasons, in implementing LA, there are some constraints according to Mahmudi and Mahmudi 2015, which are age and then gender, motivation, and then intelligence and personality. The different age learner considerably has their own abilities, intellectual skills, and then different needs, and gender differences possibly has the relation to the learner autonomy, and then motivation also lead the learners to have their own behaviors, which leads influence their way of learning, and also the variety of IQ, which shows the level of learner intelligence, plays an important role on the certain part of a language. And lastly, another factor that influences LA is personality. In fact, it is not easy to prove that the learners who have the same personality trait will have the same success in fostering LA. And the another reason is external reason. The cultural background and the learning environment might affect the implementation for the learner autonomy. For the cultural background, as introduced in the summary of the topic, Japanese learners that tend to be shy is one of examples of cultural background that orientation of the LA. And then, teacher plays a vital role in fostering LA. Real learner autonomy does not mean that the teacher does not care about the students. It is a question of the degree to which responsibility can be released to them. As a conclusion, to foster learner autonomy is not an easy endeavor in every classroom, particularly in the EFL setting. There must be commitment on both parts, teachers and learners. For the learners, in order to maintain learner autonomy, they must be aware of the social requirements of the different situations in which they are called upon to use the target language, sensitive to the varying psychological relations they will have to the different persons with whom they must communicate, and capable equally of taking initiatives and responding to the initiatives of others. And for the teacher, they need to improve their knowledge about the concept of LA and not be resistant to new approaches. And teachers should introduce the concept to the learners and try to improve learner autonomy among their students. The teachers should also maintain or even improving their professional development, like training for teachers in relation to the development of learner autonomy. It is important to promote more understanding of how to incorporate ideas such as learner autonomy into teacher training and in-service training in EFL settings so that the concept of learner autonomy can be effectively utilized in the classrooms. And that would be the end of my presentation. And before I end this presentation, I have a quote from William G. Spady. All students can learn and succeed, but not in the same way and not in the same day. So thank you very much for listening to my presentation. I'm looking forward to your feedback. And here are the references. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.